What's up, and I hope you guys do not mind a second video of the day. It's Gyro, and today we're going to be playing on Scene Crossing with the G53, and right now I'm just rampaging in this T90, crashing into everything because it's super fun. Why not? Get out of here with your 18 minds, newbie noob. I really don't know how old this gameplay is, but it's a good one. I think I go like 30 and 7 or something. Playing some Conquest. But anyways, we're going to be talking about the new patch that went live today for Battlefield 3. Now, we all know that PlayStation users that have premium are playing Armored Kill right now, so yes, I'm jelly of you guys. If you are on the Xbox or PC, we get to play it if you're a premium user next week on the 11th of September, which is my birthday. 9/11, that's right. It's Gyro's birthday. Happy birthday to me. So that will be a great birthday present for me, is Armored Kill coming out. But we're going to be talking about the new patch that went live today. They're going to be doing a whole bunch of stuff to the game overall. They're going to be changing a whole bunch of like weapons with the reload timers, and that's pretty much a cosmetic change of 1/10 of a second to a whole bunch of weapons like M416, F2000, FAMAS, KH2002, the Jackhammer, JNG90, MG36, QBU88, SVD, and PKP, SCAR-H, and AN94. Also, many other guns are getting their short and long reload reduced or increased, so there's a number of them. Now, damage output and range adjustments for certain weapons are going to be changed. The UMP is going to have increased the close range damage of the UMP, but reduced its damage over range. The UMP now has a sweet spot in close quarters battle, but suffers compared to the PP2000 at longer ranges. Now, the PP2000 is going to have increased the long range damage of the PP2000 to highlight its role as a mid-range low recoil PDW. The M1911 is going to be taking an increased minimum damage to make it fit better between the Magnums and the M9 MP443. Now, the 93R is finally going to take a nerf, and they're going to nerf down the damage and the range of it, and its recoil has been reduced for a smoother burst action to counter the reduced damage. Now, the frag rounds are finally receiving another buff after receiving the nerf so long ago, and they're going to be adjusted to do their damage in a smaller area, but to more consistently apply the maximum possible damage. So pretty much if you're hitting people spot on, you will be getting more like damage than the whole splash damage. Now, the mobile AA has been slightly increased against infantry. The AA was like simply nerfed in a previous update. The AA guns now also properly do damage to heavy tanks again, which is kind of cool because I thought it was kind of stupid that they're like, oh, you can't hit tanks no more. So, they're also going to be giving the 12-gauge buckshot close-range damage slightly increased. They're also going to be increasing the minimum range for the 40mm flechette and Titan, the cone fire for more consistent damage levels. I never used the 40mm shotgun anyway, so they're also going to be doing a couple different things, increasing the damage of the M5K, which I really don't see why that needed a damage increase. It does pretty well. They're also going to be putting a single shot or a semi-auto shot variant into the M5K. Now, the M16A3 and the M4A1 are going to have increased recoil to make them less attractive in all situations. Competing weapons like the SG-553, G36, and M416 have been improved to increase viable player choice in primary weapons. So they're trying to get people off that whole M16, M4, A1 as their main weapons, pretty much, which I like. Now, also, belt-fed machine guns are now going to be more accurate when standing and firing while aiming. So no longer will you be having a M249, M240B, PKP standing and trying to fire at a guy that's not even moving 15 feet away from you and just completely missing. and you're not going to have to be on the ground with the bipod, so I think you're going to be able to pretty much run and gun a little bit better with the light machine guns that have the bigger round count in them. Now the 44 Magnum is going to have a rate of fire reduced slightly to highlight this sidearm's role as a slow firing heavy hitter and differentiate it from the MP412 Rex. Now the MP412 Rex is going to have an increased fire rate and reload time, but it's going to be better in close quarters combat. Now they have removed burst fire from the L85 and added single shot to the L86 as is authentic for these weapons. Now they've also increased the radius of the maximum damage for the 40mm LVG, which is the brand new 40mm launcher that we have. While the overall damage level remains the same, the LVG will be lethal over a larger area. Now they have reduced the aimed accuracy bonus of the M417 with a suppressor to balance it out with other weapons. What else? Weapon fixes. They have fixed the SOFLAM wherever it will no longer lock onto your own vehicle if deployed and not immediately activated by the player. They're also adding the PKS-07 to the QBB-95, which is the 7x Russian scope. Now, vehicle-related tweaks and fixes removed flares from gunner position in choppers. With the right combination of unlocks, attack chopper could be effectively invulnerable to lock-on missiles. Removing the flares from the gunner balances the attack chopper against ground fire. I think that right there is going to be the downfall of the choppers, and people are going to be crying, and they're going to be eventually putting it back, because you can take down choppers. You just got to have a team, and you got to have friends. If you have a team and have friends, choppers can go down. Canister shell works well. Now, they're also going to be adding a laser designator unlock on the scout chopper. Has been changed from a pilot upgrade to a new stance in the co-pilot seat, which is position 4. Like the CITV turret on the heavy tank, the scout chopper's laser designator is permanently available to players who have received the unlock. Repair tool damage against enemy vehicles is being lowered again by 10%. Now, change reload behavior on tank and tank destroyer cannon weapons to prevent being able to fire two shots from different weapons quickly, one right after another. So they're probably gonna stop that, so you're not gonna be able to shoot your cannon shell then quickly switch over and shoot your canister shell so fast. What else? They also increase the damage chopper and jet rockets due to choppers, jets, and infantry. Increase the damage chopper gunners and IFVs due to choppers and jets. Fixed jets not getting top attack damage bonuses on laser designated targets. Now, changed how MCOM station defend attack kill score is calculated. The person no longer has to be arming or disarming the MCOM, you just have to be within a 5-meter radius of it. So if you're within a 5-meter radius of the MCOM and you die from a person, then you will get that ribbon more effectively. They're also fixing the premium engineer assignment, because I've heard that it's glitched, and mine is also glitched too, but I've already completed it, so I'm not worried about it. They're also finally adding Gunmaster and Domination winner ribbons and medals being added, thank God, and the co-op stars and dog tag are now properly unlockable and equipable. I don't know of any people on my friends list that actually have any of those, so who fucking cares. Other than that, I mean, they've just fixed a few different things, but I want to hear everyone's comments on about this whole new list of patches. I mean, there's some good stuff, but I really don't see a lot of it being great. I mean, them taking the flares away from the gunner and the attack chopper, for me, and I would say a lot of the people that actually know how to fly in a chopper with friends, I mean, you're not flying in an attack chopper by yourself with a random fucking noob and think that you're just going to go on an amazing spree. Now, if you have a person that's gunning for you and you're the pilot and you two are communicating, then I mean, it can just be flawless teamwork for a flawless game. So I don't know. Comment below, tell me what you all think. Anyways, video is coming to an end, so if you all enjoyed, please comment, like, favorite, and subscribe. And also, don't forget to check me out over on Twitter and follow me there, wherever you can keep up to date with whenever my videos are coming out, along when whenever I'm live streaming on Twitch TV. So it's really late right now. I think about midnight. I'm going to get up out of here. So commentary is over. I'm out. Peace.